Hello. I like to make today a rainbow zebra cake. What we need for this recipe? First of all, we need grease, a 20 centimeter, which is 8 inch, or you can use a 22 centimeter, basically 8 3/4 inch. Doesn't really matter. It's not much that difference. Round, basically baking pan. Grease and line base in the sides with non-stick baking paper. Set aside and preheat oven to 180 degrees Celsius, which is 350 Fahrenheit. And what we do is we have 4 eggs. We place them into bowl and we add 1 cup of caster sugar, and we add 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract. I use clear vanilla extract. If you don't have it, just use normal vanilla extract. So what we do is we use an electric mixer and we beat for about 5 minutes until it's thick and creamy. Once you finish beating, as you can see, it's now thick and creamy. Next step is to have 3/4 cup of vegetable oil, sunflower oil or canola oil. What we do is we add 1/2 cup of milk to the oil and just mix it together. Just to combine. And we have 2 1/2 cups, we have 2 cups of self-raising flour. And what we do is we add these ingredients basically in 2 batches. First of all, we add a little bit of milk oil mixture, just slightly folded, just a little bit. Then we add about 1/2 flour, gently folded, then we add a leftover of flour and leftover of oil and milk mixture. Just gently fold it. And we add rest of self-raising flour. So we gently fold it until just combined. And what we do is we divide this mixture evenly into 2 equal parts. So just take another bowl and divide this mixture in 2 equal parts. Also, if you want to be really precise, before you start mixing, white your first bowl and white your second bowl. And like this, you can actually use whites to measure exact amount, if you like to do so. So fold it just until combined. Once you divide your mixture among 2 bowls, they equally whited. And what we do is we first bowl we tint with a black gel food coloring. Just simply add black gel food coloring and just mix it up until it gets nice and black. And second mixture we equally divided among 6 plates, which is in each one we add different type of coloring. So let's subdivide second part into among six equally whited plates. Once you subdivide it equally, so what we do is we thin first one with red gel food coloring, second one we thin with the orange, just add small amount, do not add too much from start because it's not that much cake butter. Actually we have, as you can see, we add small amount and it's already get nice and orangey. So what we do is next we tinted third one with lemon yellow, fourth with leaf green gel food coloring, fifth with sky blue, and sixth it's purple or violet. So we have six plates with six different color. Now our second portion is completely black. So what we do with our second portion, we divide it equally among six little plates. So what we got now is six equally parts of a black colored butter and six equally parts of rainbow colored butter. So we started from first, which is black, pour right in the middle, once you place all your layers. Last one, it will be purple because we start with black and we have six black and six rainbow. So last one will be purple. Actually, center is purple. So what we do is now we place in our preheated oven and bake for about 45 minutes or until it's slightly browned and a skewer inserted in comes out clean. Once cake is baked, place basically on a stand for about 10 minutes, then turn out on a wire rack to completely cool down. By time when cake is baking, we prepare butter icing. What we do for butter icing, we need 200 grams of unsalted butter. Make sure it's at room temperature. And we add 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence. I use clear vanilla essence. If you like, if you have just a normal vanilla extract, you can use it as well. So what we do is we start beating our butter with vanilla in a bowl with the electric mixer until pale and creamy. Once it's added, what we do is we start adding our powdered icing mixture, which is we have 2.5 cups. So we start adding 1/4 cup at a time. When a butter become a pale and creamy, we start adding a powdered icing sugar about 1/4 at a time. So we add and we incorporate it. Add another one and beat until smooth. Don't forget to just scrub sides sometimes of bowl, because it's all stuck basically on the sides of bowl. So we incorporate it again. And we just keep going until we use our 2.5 cups of icing mixture. Once you finish incorporating all icing sugar to make sure mixture is nice and smooth, as you can see, it has a much lighter color and great texture. So what we do is now we just cover for now with a clean wrap or food wrap, whatever country you live in, just called differently. And what we do is we just let it aside until our cake baked and completely cooled down. Once a cake cooled, baked and completely cooled down, if you like it, you can level it, it's up to you. But I just level just a tiny bit, just at all. I think I just leave it as it is, like that. And what we do is, now we can spread our prepared frozen butter icing on top and around everywhere. And what we do is, so if you like it, you can actually split it on half and sandwich two cakes together. That's up to you. But I just simply like to have a look what we got it actually inside. So spread all over cake frosting. Once you finish, apply frosting. If you like it, just simply melt dark chocolate or dark chocolate melt, place in a snap lock bag and snip corner. So what we do is next, we just simply pipe lock lines. On top of our cake. And now we can have a look what it look like inside our rainbow zebra cake. Now we finish decorating a rainbow zebra cake, and as you can see, I just cut large chunk out to see what's actually inside. And I think it's inside is really, really great. It's really entertaining. Thank you very much for your time with me today. Everything will be in the description box. Thank you for your time. Until next time, goodbye.